Go. No movement.
All right, man. A little flashlight.
Welcome back to the channel. I'm Piotr Mokry, a Dallas-based DP, photographer, gaffer with a new one-ton grip van. Wow, was it a tough decision on choosing the right van for my production needs at this point in time. It was a $60,000 investment. I hope I made the right call. So today's shoot involves one of my viewers. This is Jay Will. He actually watches the channel. He's a big fan. He says he watches all my vlogs. He reached out to me for a shoot that was being held in Dallas over a two-day period, and he referred us out to the production company, and it was myself as a gaffer and then my friend Ryan Mitchell as a grip. The roles ended up shifting over time on the shoot because we were such a small crew that the G&E, which is grip and electric needs, weren't as high, and Jay Will was actually in need of a first AC or second AC, just kind of assisting with camera in certain situations, whether it be lens swaps or if we had to adjust tripod and things like that. We were able to be there and assist him throughout the day, and us having camera knowledge, myself and Ryan, we were able to handle everything on set and kind of be versatile. So we kind of took on multiple roles. So I didn't just stay in my lane as a gaffer, and Ryan didn't just stay in his lane as a grip, which was really exciting. So here's kind of the layout of what things were. We had three carts, one that was kind of camera heavy. Then the other one kind of had miscellaneous, had lighting on it, a little bit of camera. And then the third cart was actually what I would consider a grip cart that had miscellaneous grip. It had some stands on it, frames, modifiers, and things like that. This is all in Jay Will's new van that he picked up not too long ago. And it was really nice seeing how he had it packed out. It gave me some inspiration and ideas on my new build. The Sony Venice returns. That was the camera we were shooting on for the 2 days. It is a Venice 1, and we were actually running some really nice glass. It was Tokina Vista Primes. Had a great set with some variety, and we actually used pretty much almost every focal length on the shoot for different scenarios. You could see Jay Will here is actually taking apart the camera after day one, and what he has in his hand right now is actually... Oh, there we go. It's actually a shark fin. So you could put two batteries, whether they're V mount or gold mount, depending on the type you get, to double your battery, and you could actually hot swap them. So that was used on our last shoot that we did with the Venices as well with Joey. So here's the next morning. Jay Will kind of snuck up on me and was able to unload before I had a chance to help him. So he had things laid out. I was actually in another parking lot off to the side. He rolled up right out front, and he has things set up. You could see the Atomos Sumo set up there as a director's monitor. He has his three carts set up, and then we fine-tuned the last bit of equipment towards the end to figure out what we were going to do. But yeah, he has his setup pretty much dialed in, and he's very efficient with it.
Who are you?
I'm Jay Will. What's going on? How you doing?
So how long have you had this van?
About 3 months now.
3 months.
3 months now.
What did you have before?
I had a Ford Transit Connect.
Connect. So big, yeah. Big upgrade.
Yeah, it's a big upgrade for sure.
Awesome.
Yeah, so I love it, man.
So what kind of lights you running?
I got the Godox for the shoot, or just in general?
Just in general.
So I got the two Godox 1200 bike light lights here. These Godox panels, 150 RGB. And then some NED lights here, Forza 500s, I think we got two Forza 60s, and some mix panels, which are on the other carts over there. And some tubes and stuff up there. Got Pavo light bulbs. Yeah, just a little bit, you know. Still investing into the lighting kit. My dream lights, the Cream Source, definitely gonna get that. Sooner or later, the Vortex 8, and then some light mats, and then also, you know, that's pretty much it for now. That's my next venture in terms of lighting purchases.
So what camera are we shooting with today?
We're shooting on the Sony Venice, which is actually on this cart right here. It's in that.
Awesome.
You know.
Yeah, so we saw that yesterday, yeah. Setting it up.
Mm-hmm.
Sweet. What carts are you running?
I'm budget-friendly options, you know, Pro Aim right now. But eventually I'll get to the bigger carts. And probably just have some thicker ones I've seen on set, but you know, this is a tool at the end of the day.
So this is your camera cart that we have loaded up with stuff, and then over here is your kind of catch-all grip cart?
Kinda, you know. I just use the regular cart and converted it to a grip cart for, you know, budget-friendly options. I try to make my homemade one with, like, trash can bins. I don't know if you've seen those Rubbermaid trash cans. I had three of them stacked up, and worst mistake ever. I had it on this thing right here.
So on day two, I was able to pick up a few BTS shots. It wasn't as restricted, but you can see the flag here, which is the solid, is blocking the light from actually hitting the table and overexposing the shot. So it's cutting it just right. These are the new Godox MG1200 bicolor lights. They're the NOLED series. They have special mounts. They're not just your standard Bowens mount. This light was beefy. Oh my gosh, it was a monster. And you could see Jay, Will, and Ryan over there chit-chatting about certain things. We're trying to get the shot set up. And the thing that was really common here is constantly moving quickly, fast setups. We didn't have much time. It just had to be versatile nonstop. That was a little bit of a edge light, hair light, and it was a NAND light panel. On a rolling stand, which is, that's a short low boy rolling stand. And then we had a C-stand extension pop right in off a turtle. And then Philip right there is the client for the agency or production company. And he was able to direct the client and get us moving quicker. And he actually has a great background in shooting production. So he was able to help out a lot and understood our challenges and was great to work with. He's an awesome guy. He's very laid back, but he knows what he wants, and he gets us to get those shots. And then Jay Will was in charge. He was the DP for the shoot, so he kind of guided us, myself and Ryan, on what he wanted and what he was looking for. We gave some suggestions in certain situations, and we just pushed through with it, and we were able to get results quickly and efficiently with working as a team and working together. So that was really nice. You can see it's a big setup. One of the cool shots of the day was a top-down shot. We actually are moving those lamps right now to get them out of the way so they're not in the shot, because they hung really low. And then Jay Will's pulling out his app to check focal length to see what it's going to look like from that angle. So he picks the camera, he picks the lens setup, and then he's able to see his focal length. That's actually the 1200 just pounding off right there, and it's a little frosted there, and we're just getting enough return where it looks like it's coming from outside. We couldn't go outside and, you know, lift it up or anything like that. Here's the Venice that's actually on a jib for the top down shot, which the jib was provided by Jay Will as well. So he was actually the one that brought the jib. He knew we were doing the top down, and this is the setup we went with. There's safety chains all around, or safety cables, but we also, once we get it close to being over, we end up adding another safety to make sure everything is secure. But this setup, it's always risky when you're doing overhead shots. We cleared everyone out from underneath as we were working on it, and right now they are trying to balance it. And if you remember some of my other videos, weight on one side has to match the weight on the other side. You can adjust it. If you see Ryan doing right now, he's pushing it in to try to make it balance where it's floating on its own, so there's no excess weight on one side or the other side to make it safe. So he's getting it where it's just to the right point. He's adding those stoppers for the weight, and then we're going to extend it over this railing. But Ryan made sure that it's not just freestanding over the railing, but when it does go over the railing, it's actually supported by the railing. So that's another safety measure in place. So you have it boomed out, and then you have it supported by the railing, and then there's safety cables, you know, to match. And this was at 25 millimeter lens, and then we switched to the 18 for a second shot. So you see the 25, you could actually see a ratchet strap cable that's a safety, that black one going back. We set a tripod case bag that had some cushion so it wouldn't damage the actual railing. And you see that big old heavy camera hanging down, and then wireless going to the actual sumo monitor so we could check focus, framing, and everything like that. So it ended up working out really well. This is scary, guys. No matter how experienced you are, it's always risky. It's always scary. Take precautions. Be safe. Do everything possible. Now they're switching over to the 18. Like I said, we did multiple roles. This is not normally the role of a grip, but we had a skeleton crew or a smaller crew, whatever you want to call it, and we worked together and we made things happen. There were no egos on this shoot. That's what was really great. If we needed help, we asked for it. If someone needed help, we offered it.
Hey, what's up, y'all? We're doing a top-down shot with the Sony Venice. Here we go. Using on the jib right here. We're shooting on the 18mm. Client requested that, but we shot it on 25 earlier on a different shot. We got the whole jib shot right here with the, you know, rigged up. And then here's the monitor feed if you want to see what it looks like with the 18mm. So yeah, that's what we're doing. Couldn't have done it without these guys, Peter and Ryan.
This was the last shot of the last day. It had to be really high. We were running out of time. Jay Will said, let's grab a ladder. I'm getting up top. I'm holding off this shot. And we got it. It was great working with him. He's based out of the Austin area. Like I said, he reached out to me after watching my channel and wanted me to come work on this project with him. If you want me on your next project, feel free to reach out. Maybe we can make it happen. I'd like to make it happen. So let's get to the nitty gritty. Mercedes-Benz. That's the van I chose. I was so torn up between which van to get. Should I get the all-wheel drive one that's lifted, short roof, high roof? This is a lifted all-wheel drive. It's a 2023. I decided not to get this one. Then this was a 170 wheelbase, which is longer than the one we just saw. So from wheel to wheel, it's 170. It has dually wheels in the back so it can handle more payload. And it's the longer version, the 170, but it's not the 170 extended. I decided not to get it. This is a 170 extended with the dually wheels on the back. It's called the 3500 XD. This thing is the biggest one you can get from Mercedes-Benz. And I was like, man, this is awesome. I had the budget for it. I could afford it. But you know what? I didn't get it. And the reason I didn't get this one is it was just too big. Look at it sticking out of the parking spot, the length on it. Oh my gosh, those black wheels were awesome. It was so nice. I was so tempted. So here's my old van, shined up. Look at the gloss on that, okay? I waxed it. I sprayed waxed it, but I put some effort into cleaning it up because I wanted to get the most value out of it. And how much did I get out of it? They paid me $21,000 trade-in on this van. I bought it for $25,000 four and a half years ago. And then I got this one. So with $21,000 in savings, I was able to get this van at a huge reduction in price because of my trade-in. It also saved me on taxes. And the reason I chose this setup over the other ones that were longer, that were taller, that were different is one of the main things, parking, just the ability to park in one spot and not stick out, but I have the ability to be tall. And I know that doesn't get me into parking garages, but my other van was already too tall for most parking garages. I can actually fit in a regular spot. This gives me versatility for my current wants and needs. And maybe next year I could get a super long one that's dedicated to grip only. But right now I'm doing both. And a funny thing did happen. I bought my van the exact same time that...
Whoa! What are you doing?
What are you doing? Why are you here?
No, I was here buying first, and then you show up. So we bought our vans on the exact same day, exact same time.
What are the odds?
This van is far from ready to meet my needs as a gaffer, grip, and one-man band shooter DP. So first thing I did is I got a bulkhead, I got a divider, and it was really important because of safety. And I was able to find one for $200. The aftermarket ones are over $1,000, and this is actually Mercedes OEM. I had to install it myself, and I had to cut into my brand new van's trim to make it fit. I got it installed. there's a huge amount of things that I want to do in here to get it prepped and ready for my needs. Two carts, one cart, three carts, whatever the case may be, shelving. So stick around for that journey. Also, I was able to tour Ryan's van and show it off. And this is the long one with the tall roof, the big one that I was considering. I was like, hey man, I may be getting a van just like you, but you know what? I did not end up getting it, but I did get a tour of it while we were on our shoot. So he showed it off, showed off the lift. I'm really interested in getting a lift like that. Should I go lift or ramp? But yeah, maybe in the next episode, I'll show you guys the tour of his van.